If I could choose one word to describe CES, it's innovation.
Huge.
Incredible.
Opportunity.
Informative.
Revolutionary.
Important. Exuberant.
Passionate.
Inclusive.
Opportunity.
Techgasm.
There is no one word, there are four. It's the greatest show on earth.
I'm shuffling.
Ladies and gentlemen, President and Chief Executive Officer of the Consumer Electronics Association, Gary Shapiro.
Welcome to the 2013 International CES, the world's largest and greatest innovation event. Innovation is our best hope for growth, jobs, and advancement of the human condition. As we debate how government should tax and spend, we can agree on one thing, and that is that encouraging innovation is a strategy that helps economic growth, reduces budget deficits, and it's good for nations and for people. So let us start by recognizing those who brought us to the dance, including the small entrepreneurs and the big companies taking risks and trying new things by innovating and exhibiting at CES. So please join me in applauding the over 3,300 exhibitors at the 2013 International CES. Woo! Now, of course, you know that CES is more than a trade show. It is a gathering of the brightest minds and the top leaders from many industries. It is for entrepreneurs, dreamers, imaginers, leaders, analysts, strategists, reporters, investors, and those seeking a glimpse into the future. And in this tough economic climate, CES offers comfort, excitement, and of course, optimism. It's where we can see a brighter future fueled by innovation. You know, at CEA, we foster innovation as a national strategy and as part of our mission all year long in several ways. First, of course, the obvious. We host the International CES. It's about innovation. It is awe-inspiring, it's optimistic, and it's record-setting this year with 1.9 million net square feet of exhibit space. But for the cynics among you, how could you not get inspired if you stroll through Eureka Park with over 150 startup companies here to have their opportunity at living the American dream? Or we're solving problems. Our digital health portion of the show is up over 24%. iLounge, the Apple ecosystem, didn't even exist 5 years ago. And now it could be one of the biggest trade shows in the country by its own right. Over 400 companies, over 120,000 net square feet of exhibit space. And if you're into cars, wow, North Hall, 8 of the 10 largest auto companies. Over 100,000 square feet of exhibit space featuring not only the car companies, but aftermarket solutions, not only focused on entertainment and navigation, but also increasingly on safety. And for those of you in this room last night, Born Mobile, Paul Jacobs of Qualcomm, what a pre-show keynote opening speech. And what a great surprise to see Steve Ballmer of Microsoft back up here on stage. And as you walk through the central hall and other portions of the CES, you'll see great advancements in video, connected television, OLED, Ultra HD. And this has also become the largest app event in the world. We have an app contest featuring over 25 teams competing to win $25,000 here. We have a wall of apps. We even have an appy hour. Now, another thing that the Consumer Electronics Association does to foster innovation, in addition to producing these events, is we also have something called the Innovation Movement. The Innovation Movement is a group of about a quarter million Americans, and hopefully growing by some of you in the audience, who believe that innovation is an important solution for our national problems. And in 2012, we had a really good year of accomplishment. We ended up finishing out the free trade agreements with South Korea and Panama, Colombia, because we believe that free trade is important to innovation for everyone in the world. We fought for additional spectrum, and we got a law passed, signed by the president, and now the FCC is working on, which would allow spectrum to be repurposed for wireless broadband. That's terrific. That's what we need. And of course, the innovations movement is fighting for an open internet. Last year on the stage, I was talking about SOPA and PIPA and the concern that it was rushing through Congress. Well, within 2 weeks, over 5 million Americans had contacted Congress, and overnight, within 24 hours, some 40 members of Congress withdrew their name from that legislation, and it died. In fact, calling yes. There will never be SOPA PIPA legislation with that name on it. It's kind of like calling your kid Adolf. Another thing we're fighting for, which we certainly in the national forefront of a legislative issue, but is not quite over the finish line, is CEA's volunteer leadership believes strongly that the best thing for the innovation industry in the United States moving forward is a healthy U.S. economy in the midterm and the long term. And that requires that we make some hard choices and deal with our deficit. We have, as an association, maybe the only one in Washington that embraced the Simpson-Biles recommendations, their calls for shared sacrifice, because we believe an economy in the U.S. that's strong is good for our country and our industry. Another way we're promoting innovation is a launch we have at this show, i3. It is innovation, a new magazine, and it is thick. It's examining innovation stories, and you can get a copy at the Experience CEA booth. And please consider signing up for it. It's free. Now, we've also done something at CEA. We've tried to change the language of innovation. We believe so strongly in the power of innovation that we coined a new term, ninja innovation. What's it about? Discipline, determination, passion, thinking outside the box. Indeed, ninja innovation is the name of our new book. And it's about what leads to success, how failure can help us succeed, and the common characteristics of successful companies through the lens of the consumer electronics industry. The book highlights ninja warriors, IBM, Amazon, eBay, Ford, Monster, HealthSpot, and people like Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, and Jeff Bezos. Ninja innovation is a companion piece to our first book, The Comeback, which provided a public policy blueprint to encourage innovation. And all proceeds from both books go back to CEA to help fund industry initiatives. You can get your copy online or at the show. What ninjas do is they collaborate. and they solve problems, and they don't always go to the government. And that's why I'm pleased to introduce the result of two industries working together to solve problems and create opportunities.
Ultraviolet, an entirely new way to collect, access, and enjoy your movies and TV shows at home or on the go with unprecedented support.
You've given these people everything.
Not everything. Not yet.
Now the movies you buy, own, and collect are always with you.
I love you. I love you too.
The future of entertainment is here. More movies, more devices, easier than ever. Ultraviolet, your movies in the cloud.
I am so pleased that we have executives here to announce a groundbreaking cross-industry digital promotion between their studios and several major consumer electronics manufacturers. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to the president of Warner Home Video, Ron Sanders.
Thank you very much, Gary, for that warm introduction. We really appreciate sharing the stage with you and us today as we also share our common vision for the future of home entertainment. I'm joined today by David Bishop, Craig Kornblau, Mike Dunn, and Steve Beeks. And we're very happy to be here today to announce an upcoming partnership between all of the Hollywood studios and several major electronics companies, including the biggest and most respected manufacturers of big screen TVs, Blu-ray players, and makers of some of the most innovative hardware we'll be seeing at the show this week. Later this year, consumers who purchase select connected televisions or connected Blu-ray players from these manufacturers will receive up to 10 free Ultraviolet movies. This Get Connected Ultraviolet Movie Starter Pack campaign that we're announcing today is a partnership with LG, Panasonic, Philips, Samsung, Sony, Toshiba, and Vizio. This is a great cross-promotion for the industry because it provides extra value to hardware consumers while providing yet another gateway for movie fans to enjoy their favorite films digitally, anytime, anywhere, and on the device of their choosing. Ultraviolet allows movie consumers to link their digital retail accounts together so that any purchase can be played back or downloaded from virtually any connected device. Consumers get permanent cloud storage of their collection without being limited to any one retailer's device or technology. They can always get their movie. Ultraviolet files can be securely streamed or downloaded to an installed base of literally hundreds of millions of connected devices. Over the coming year, we can expect to see additional retailers and platforms offering consumers more and more seamless ways to get their collections and their new purchases into the Ultraviolet cloud. Along those lines, we're excited to see new in-home disc-to-digital services, such as those that Walmart and Best Buy and Flixster are bringing to market. These services will allow consumers to create Ultraviolet-enabled digital copies from their existing DVD collections from home and unlock the value of their libraries. We're extremely optimistic about in-home disc-to-digital and believe it will have a profound impact on the growth of Ultraviolet as well as on consumer satisfaction. Ultraviolet has had an extraordinary year. We expect to hit 10 million Ultraviolet accounts in the weeks ahead, more than double the number of registrations that we had just 6 months ago. And there are now over 8,500 Ultraviolet movies available in the marketplace. In closing, it's important to note that all of the activity from manufacturers, from retailers, and studios will continue to increase consumer awareness, interest, and in participation in Ultraviolet. As each company promotes their own individual products and services, we believe the collective benefit will lead to exponential growth for electronic sell-through, for video on demand, and the entire home entertainment industry. On behalf of the major studios represented here, I'd like to thank you for giving us the opportunity to join you today and announce this bold new partnership between the electronics industry and Hollywood, and to thank Gary and the entire CEA for their help in delivering this open ecosystem that's going to be better content for consumers. Thanks so much and enjoy the show. That's great. Thanks a
lot. Nice to have you. Thank you. Thank you. Enjoy, guys. Have a great show.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you again. Thank you, Ron. Very exciting to see two industries collaborating. You know, for those of you who know, there's a little bit of history. Sometimes we disagree on things and sometimes we agree, but when we keep the government out of it, usually we agree. Ninja innovators, of course, shine a bright hope of light in these very uncertain times. And the products launching this week at CES, some 20,000, from Ultra HD TV to sensing technologies to connected vehicles and beyond, breathe renewed energy into our economy. Now, our industry did well in turbulent times in 2012. In the United States, we grew at 4.7% and passed the $200 billion mark. And for 2013, we're also projecting growth. We think we'll hit $210 billion, a 2.7% increase. And while we had a lot of success in 2012, much work remains to be done. We do need a political and legal environment that's hospitable for companies to keep their operations and jobs in the United States. We need the United States government to have a ninja moment of its own. We need a government that solves problems without regard to political party. And I urge you to check out nolabels.org, which focuses on solving problems rather than political party, which CEA helped form. You know, we need to accept the fact that as baby boomers, we have promised ourselves benefits that we cannot afford or our children cannot afford to pay. And it's time we as a nation, and our leaders especially, man up. We also need to focus on things which are important to the innovation industry alone. For example, patent reform. CEA will be fighting this year to stop patent trolls. We'll also be, thank you. We'll also be focusing on strategic immigration, getting the best and the brightest people to the United States. They're certainly coming here for their education. We should be keeping them here once they get their PhDs and master degrees. We'll be working to protect and foster entrepreneurs and startups because startup innovators are true ninjas. They are jump-starting our economy and paving the way for America's future. Look, we had a lot of success last year by getting the Jobs Act passed. The Jobs Act allows entrepreneurs to raise money easier without the burden of the SEC, of Sarbanes-Oxley, many other rules and laws. It allows crowdfunding. All we're asking at this point, after Congress on a bipartisan basis and President Obama signed it, is for the SEC to stop blocking it. It's not too big an ask. We also are promoting entrepreneurship, obviously, as I mentioned, through Eureka Park and through the Consumer Electronics Show. And let me tell you about that. And why we operate the International CES how we do. In the early 1980s, I attended my first board meeting for the CEA. And at the time, there was Ray Gates, who opened Panasonic for the United States. He was speaking as the chairman of the board, and there was a proposal to raise the cost of exhibit space at CES. And he said, you know, Panasonic, which at the time was the largest exhibitor, he said, we can afford it. It's a rounding error. But the fact is, we have to make CES available for anyone with an idea to come here and expose their idea to literally tens of thousands of retailers, investors, partners, distributors, and media from around the world. And that philosophy has imbued CES for 30 years. That yes, we love the big companies that are here, but this industry must always be open for small companies. And our staff knows that people who come here are maybe investing their life savings, their credit card, debt to the max just to get that one chance, and we have to make it a good opportunity for them. Indeed, to push what we're doing for entrepreneurs in a bigger way, we have created a new membership category at CEA, simply focused at startups. We're launching it just this week, and we're urging companies that are startups to join us so that they could have access not only to the public policy, which is important, but also we do a lot of mentoring, research, statistics, things like that. So we are trying to walk the walk and talk the talk. We also have a CEA-supported documentary we're releasing in the next hour called Silicon Prairie. It highlights ninja innovators across the United States. Now, you can find ninja innovators and startups all around the world, of course. You can find them in large multinational companies. You can find them in Hollywood studios, in trade association memberships, like CEA and others of our colleagues. And you can even find a few working in government. But many of you here this morning are ninja innovators, and we want to tell your stories too. In fact, this year we're launching an app you can download called I Am Innovation. Now, through this app, we want to collect stories of innovation and personal views on the importance of fostering innovation. We will take these collective stories to lawmakers to help them understand why we need pro-innovation policies. We encourage you to download the app to share your story and views. Now, you can download it at declareinnovation.com. I'd like to talk a bit about the ninja, because the ninja is what it's about. The ninja goes into a battle with very few weapons and few resources. He can't rely on his greater numbers or his superior firepower, because the enemy will have him beat on both counts. But the ninja is not without advantages. He has the cunning, creativity, training, and smarts to use anything and everything to his advantage. The ninja may make mistakes, but he will not be defeated by them. The ninja has no choice but to live by the words that I have spoken so many times on this stage: innovate or die. It is what defines our industry and our nation. Yes, certainly innovation is not easy, and innovation is scary. Innovation disrupts and it sometimes kills existing business models, legacy ideas, and preconceptions. But the truth remains that our industry and every company in it must continue to innovate or we die. And anyone, though, can be a ninja, because being a ninja is a way of thinking. It's a way of looking at and approaching the world. It's a philosophy of being your best, a way of solving problems, a commitment to making yourself and your enterprise better. Ninjas imagine the future and then they create it. So as you walk the halls of the CES, you will see here thousands of ninjas turning imagination into reality. You will see how innovation can solve our global challenges and provide new hope, prosperity, and revolutionize our world for the good. I hope it inspires you the way it inspires me. And I hope that it awakens in each of you the ninja inside you, not just for these few days, but throughout the year. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your time today. I'll be back in a few minutes to introduce to you our upcoming keynote speaker. For now, enjoy the show.
Good morning, everyone. Hopefully you are all sufficiently caffeinated and didn't gamble or party too hard last night. I'm Lisa Ling and I'm delighted to be your host today as Panasonic shares their vision for the future with you. Now, many of you probably think of Panasonic as just a television manufacturer. Well, think again. Over the next hour, we're going to take you on a journey into the full range of Panasonic's innovative solutions. And you'll meet the man driving the company's transformation at this pivotal point in its evolution. But first, let's begin by hearing from people whose opinion Panasonic values the most, their customers.
Well, what matters most to me, what matters most to us, well, now more than ever, it's our family.
I travel to incredible places for my work. You know, it's really amazing to see the natural beauty that our planet has to offer, but also the devastating toll that our ways have really taken on the environment. If we don't make handling that a priority, then nothing else is really going to matter.
It's very important for businesses to understand the importance of delivering first-class service. The consumer experience has to be top-notch, otherwise the disposable income that is limited in this time and age is not going to be spent on the products and services that you're trying to pitch.
I think the hardest part of living away from home was just getting adjusted to a new environment. When you're always running from place to place, it's hard to stay connected, and I need technology that can help me with that. So wherever I go, I want to make sure that I'm not too far from my parents and my friends.
We feel very fortunate at this point in our lives. What matters the most is giving back. If I had to sum it up in one word, community.
I mean, my life is all about the latest technology. I'm like the poster child for smarter, faster, and more connected. For me, if it's not connecting us to each other and what we care about, then what good is it? So from that perspective, the answer is easy. It's all about people.
With more than 100 patents to his name and several more pending, the gentleman I'm about to introduce has played a key role in engineering many of Panasonic's core technologies. Today, In his current role as head of the company, we are delighted that he's here to share where Panasonic is headed in 2013 and beyond. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the 2013 International CES opening keynote, the president and CEO of Panasonic, Kazuhiro Tsuga.
Thank you, Gary. As Gary mentioned in his introduction, though my current responsibilities have expanded somewhat since I began at Panasonic in 1979, I am first and foremost an engineer. This is my training, my perspective, and my passion. Some people think of engineers as rational and analytical. This is true, but we are also passionately driven to solve problems, to turn idealistic visions into useful realities. In fact, most of us care quite deeply about making the world we live in better. Many of you may think of Panasonic as a television manufacturing company, for very good reason. For nearly 100 years, we have been making a vast range of products that are enhancing the lives of customers around the world. But the fact is, not a single one of those products would exist without a fundamental expertise as an engineering company. And with our long-standing commitment to sustainability, this makes us uniquely able to offer innovative solutions that are both eco and smart. This is a Panasonic I want to share with you today, an eco engineering company powered by the efforts of thousands of employees around the world who, just like me, are driven to make the world we live in better. So, what is it that drives us? At Panasonic, the answer is quite simple. People, customers. Now more than ever, we are committed to creating real value for our customers. Our ability to do this is based on two fundamental things. First, we are listening deeply to what our customers want and need, often long before they ever purchase our products. In fact, there are Panasonic Lifestyle Research Centers that have been created in key regions around the world to do just that. And second, we are creating lasting relationships with customers that continue long after they purchase our product. This is being achieved through a range of exciting services that you'll be hearing about shortly. As we share the full scope of our vision this morning, I think you'll see that our future is being built on far more than a single product category. And our contribution to people's lives is extending far beyond the living room. We are focusing our business activities around four broad areas in which we impact people's lives: residential, non-residential, mobility, and personal. But these distinctions have no meaning without the one thing that unites them: people. With people at the center of all our activities, we want to add value to customers' lives, wherever they are, from home to community, work to play, and automobile to airplane. One way to achieve this is by maximizing the tremendous growth potential in the B2B category. Through a new business model that goes far beyond selling hardware, and offers total solutions that include software and services as well. In collaboration with our global business customers, we are enhancing consumers' lives in areas where you might not think of Panasonic, including automotive, retail, avionics, and energy. Today, we'll be sharing numerous examples of this B2B2C approach in action. And you'll meet some of our top business customers. In addition, you'll be hearing about the important role Panasonic Cloud Services will play in offering our customers a more connected and intuitive user experience. A few moments ago, I spoke about our drive to make the world better. But what does it really mean? A better world? At Panasonic, we would not presume to answer that question for you. Our job is to give you the products, solutions, and services that will allow you to create the better world you want. Whoever you are and wherever you are, over the next hour, you'll hear what real Panasonic customers want and need to make their worlds better. And you'll see how we are responding. Perhaps there may be a few surprises along the way. But we begin with the area of Panasonic innovation that should not surprise any of you, your TV.
Ideal TV experience, I think, would be much more like my phone, whereas things are organized, they're personal, they're interactive. The things that I use most are most readily available to me. I think customization, it would be amazing.
So I gave up cable a while ago. All the shows I watch come to me over the internet from a bunch of different sources, but if the content I love could all be in like a single seamless service where I could just choose what I want to watch, that'd be awesome.
The television industry here in the US is experiencing tremendous change. The next 5 years will transform it more than the last 25. Clearly, customers are hungry for this. As Lisa said earlier, when people think of Panasonic, they often think of television. Of course, we are always raising the bar to offer our customers state-of-the-art TVs and audiovisual products. That's not going to change. What today's consumers are desiring in a TV is more than just beautiful picture quality. They are expecting easy access to content, flexible choices, interaction with friends and other viewers, a simple and intuitive user experience. In other words, they don't want just another screen. They want a variable addition to their entertainment universe. Smart, intelligent, friendly, easy to use. At Panasonic, we are not sitting idle. We are anticipating and shaping the future. Today, I'd like to share a vision for the future of TV, your TV. We wanted to give you the ability to personalize and customize. We wanted to provide you with a great new experience while giving you choice and freedom. So, what is this great new experience? It's all you could ever want from your TV and more. Broadcast channels, video on demand, smart search, and a rich social experience at your fingertips. But rather than telling you about it, Lisa and I are going to show it to you Hello, Lisa.
Hi, Tsuga-san.
Thank you for being here today to help us tell our story. Clearly, we are not the only ones with news to share. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Tsuga-san. Yes, I have 2 months to go, and I'm extremely nervous, but this is not about me today. This is about you, and I'm so excited to be here. And one of the great things about hosting this event is I've gotten a sneak preview of everything you're going to see today, including Panasonic's concept for your TV. Now, as Tsuga-san knows, I've been working in this business for well over 20 years, and I really think that what Panasonic is up to is going to considerably impact my industry.
We hope so.
So let's walk through the demo for Panasonic's new user interface that I saw the other day. Shall we do that?
Of course.
Okay. So right now, we are watching a broadcast channel. But when you access preferred content and information, your TV can take you to a personalized user interface.
All I have to do is say, my home screen. The built-in camera and face recognition technologies bring up my personal page.
I love that feature, and that's such a cute picture of you. And I'm sensing from this this screen here that someone is really into golf, perhaps?
Oh, yes. This is a photo of my favorite golf course in Half Moon Bay. In addition, at the bottom of that screen, you can see the Viera Connect application, some of the news feed I follow on Twitter, weather information, and my photo album.
I hope you're following me on Twitter, Tsuga-san. Now, one of the great things about the album is that your personal photos are stored in the cloud and can be viewed at any time on a large TV screen.
That's right. This new home screen is designed to personalize your TV experience and give you direct access to both the latest information and all your favorite content.
But there's a lot more to your TV, isn't there?
There is. We want to go beyond merely connecting your TV to the internet. By enhancing that connection, we can take both our definition and our experience of a smart device to a far deeper level, and not just for consumers. We believe that smart devices can empower a whole ecosystem of partners to develop new business models that will bring about the next generation TV experience.
Absolutely, and to tell us more about this exciting new concept, please welcome the co-founder and CEO of Specific Media, Tim Vanderhook. Tim, tell us about this new partnership.
I'm really excited to be here today to support the leadership that Panasonic is taking to enable new and exciting experiences, such as the ones we're showing this morning. Today, we're announcing the partnership between Specific Media and Panasonic that will deliver the next generation TV experience. For the past year, we've expanded our partnership with Panasonic, working on technology to enable the entire television ecosystem to offer a better experience for consumers, but also by providing greater value for content owners, operators, and advertisers. This new technology will be embedded in Panasonic Connected Television and deliver an entirely new experience designed to give users access to more content, better interactivity, content recommendations, and personalized advertising delivered through the internet.
So Tim, this idea of empowering entire television ecosystems is really interesting. How do you think this will impact content owners?
Yeah, we're enabling content owners to leverage digital technology to give consumers a deeper level of engagement with their content, while also still using their current TV service provider. In addition, this next generation TV service allows for a second screen experience that will bring the audience closer to their favorite content.
And of course, you mentioned advertisers. They must be chomping at the bit for this.
That's right. On the advertising side, we're bringing the best the digital world has to offer. This includes data, personalization, and analytics to the most impactful medium in the world, that 30-second TV spot. Now, personalized TV advertising has been sought after for many, many years by the industry. With this partnership, we're making this long-standing opportunity a reality today.
Tim, let's show them what it looks like.
Creating the next generation TV experience, fit for the 21st century. Our goal is to provide consumers with an enhanced TV viewing experience around any content from any source. We have natively integrated our service within Panasonic Connected TVs, enabling this rich experience using the Panasonic remote control. Discovery provides recommendations for the end user based on an intelligent mix of their past viewing behavior, programs they have rated or watched, as well as programs their friends have rated or watched. Users can also get recommendations by clicking on similar shows. The guide enables users to scroll forward and backward in time, and consumers can see what their friends are watching and which programs they have invites for. Users can also apply dynamic filters to the guide using a unique heat map mechanism. The heat map filters allow users to sort the full guide based on a number of criteria, such as recommendations, what everyone has watched, what friends have watched, and ratings. By clicking the rated filter, the guide dynamically shows heat map technology, visually sorting programs based on their ratings. Users can chat in real time with their online friends using companion applications. Chat sessions can be viewed on both the companion device and the TV at the same time, so that users can continue to watch and chat with one another. Users can also choose to see when their friends start watching TV and when their friends change channels. Intelligent ads provide users with ads relevant to the content they are currently viewing. The service also enables users to access a growing catalog of high-quality linear broadcast channels and on-demand content, all delivered straight to the user's connected TV.
Okay, now I'm never going to want to leave home. Thanks a lot for that. Of course, the collaboration of broadcast partners is an essential element in the next generation TV experience. And to share that perspective, here's the 2012 Broadcasting Cable Multi-Platform Broadcaster of the Year, the President of Sales and Marketing at Univision, Keith Turner.
At Univision, we are constantly seeking new technologies and tools that allow for deeper engagement with our content. Second screen experiences and the communication tools that were just shown help us bring our audience together and allow them a new level of interactivity that was previously unavailable. Engaging our audience with a premium content is always our priority, but now we have the ability to deliver addressable and targeted advertising messages that are personalized to the viewer. This is a better experience for consumers and creates less waste for advertisers. Panasonic and Specific Media are delivering a product that will create a better experience for consumers and add more value to content owners, operators, and brands. I applaud them both for taking a leadership position that benefits all participants of the television industry. Thank you and have a great CES.
Thank you, team. We are very excited to partner with you in making the next generation TV experience a reality. Thank you. Our concept for your TV embodies everything that we want you to know about where Panasonic is going. How we are expanding our reach from hardware manufacturer to a total solutions and service provider. How working closely with other global leaders has never been more essential. And most importantly, how these things are allowing us to build deeper, ongoing relationships with customers, all with one goal in mind: to add maximum value to people's lives. With these initiatives, we are beginning a truly new era at Panasonic. But rest assured, engineering new audiovisual technology that meets customer needs is as important as ever. We'll continue to lead the industry in the development of plasma and LCD TVs and a whole range of innovative new products. To help me share the latest news, please welcome the Chief Executive Officer of Panasonic North America, Joe Taylor.
Thanks, Cass. Great to be here with you today. That's wonderful news about your TV.
It is. But the TV experience at Panasonic will always involve pushing the boundaries of our engineering skills.
That's true. And two of the TV technologies that we're most excited about are 4K and OLED. And as many of you know, the advantage of 4K is that it gives you four times the resolution of your current HD TV. That's the same standard that audiences are enjoying in digital cinemas around the world. And with OLED, we're just beginning to explore the possibilities for thinner, lighter displays with incredible image quality and lower energy consumption.
Each of these technologies answers a different set of needs for our customers. But rather than rushing to bring one or the other to market, I asked our engineers to come up with a better solution. one that doesn't force our customers to choose. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the world's first large screen 4K OLED display created by printing technology. Thank you. What really sets this television apart is the stunning picture quality that the synergy of these two technologies makes possible. In addition to video, it brings a high 4K resolution and rich color of photos vividly to life.
And images with text and detailed illustrations are equally amazing. At just 27 pounds and less than half inch thick, this 56-inch TV exemplifies how incredibly thin and light OLED can be.
Yes, that's a half weight of a normal 4K display.
And as we just mentioned, the engine driving Panasonic OLED is our printing technology, which gives us the ability to make panels that are larger and more affordable than our competitors.
But the only way to fully appreciate the impact of this display is to see it up close. Please be sure to visit the Panasonic booth and experience it for yourself.
Everyone's talking about smart homes, smart this, smart that. But what does it really mean? If smart doesn't balance what's good for us personally in the world we live in, is it really smart?
Well, as a green home designer, it's my responsibility to bring options to the table that my client can incorporate into the design that technology has provided that's sustainable and affordable. And when you get those two elements together, you end up with a smart design.
At my house, I'm the technology guy. My parents don't quite understand the cloud yet, or how it ties all of my devices together. But they'll get it sometime, eventually.
From our rich history delivering state-of-the-art audiovisual products and appliances, and moving into the fully connected future being made possible by the cloud, Panasonic is committed to making your life at home smarter and more energy efficient than you ever dreamed possible. And when it comes to home energy solutions, it was only after we invited Lisa Ling to join us here today that we discovered just how deep her personal commitment runs. Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Joe.
So, I think almost all of us know you as a journalist who followed green issues, but your commitment's much deeper. You and your husband, Paul, just built the completely energy neutral, LEED Platinum certified home. First one in California, right?
We did. That was a mouthful. Actually, the first one in our community, and those are photos of our home behind Joe back there. We've been planning to start a family for a long time, and when we decided to do so, we wanted to create an energy efficient home for our child to grow up in. And we worked with this amazing architect who specializes in sustainable design, and he integrated a whole range of energy solutions into our home, including a beautifully designed array of Panasonic solar panels. We have over 60 of them at our house, and you can see how he incorporated them into the design in some of those photographs. And the best thing about it is our electricity bill every month, zero. And we also have a collection of Panasonic ventilation fans as well.
So when it comes to this topic, you're not just a journalist, you're one of our customers.
I am, but to tell you the truth, I had no idea how deep Panasonic's commitment to green innovation really is until I started working on this project.
Yeah, so as Tsuga-san said earlier, sustainability has been an essential part of our Panasonic DNA for a very long time. And one of the measures that we track is last year, Interbrand named us again as one of the top 10 green global brands.
And that's up four spots from last year to number six, which is the highest ranking of any CE company, right?
It is. We're really pleased with the progress we're making.
Well, you should be. So, Joe, why don't you take us through the four pillars of Panasonic's energy solution strategy?
Sure. Everything we do is built on integrated solutions to create, store, save, and manage energy. And when it comes to creating energy, in addition to the solar panels, like the ones you have on your home, we bring to market innovative products like hydrogen fuel cells.
But you're also focusing on storing energy, which is also so important. I think that's a pretty new idea for most customers in the US, right?
It really is, but it's gained a tremendous amount of traction overseas, and we expect the same thing to occur here in the States. And if you use Panasonic lithium ion batteries, for instance, to store, you can take the energy that you've created during the day and you can use it at times when you need it most, in the evening when it's raining or during power outages. But of course, engineering products that save energy has been a top priority at Panasonic for a very long time, including our home appliances, our audiovisual products, and even our LED lighting.
Well, the thing I'm really excited about and fascinated by is Panasonic's approach to managing energy with something called Smart Energy Gateway, or SEG. What is SEG?
So SEG essentially links and manages all the devices in your home. And it can be controlled through a variety of smart devices, either in the home or remotely. And it checks power conditions throughout the day, and it can help you manage how and where you can save energy in the home. But really, the key takeaway for Panasonic Home Energy Solutions is that we're using the same template that we use for consumers in a much broader space, including businesses and whole communities around the world.
Smart homes, so smart. But there's one more element of home solutions we haven't touched on yet. Like energy, it's something that's going to play a key role in Panasonic's future, and that's the cloud. Tell us about that.
So, Lisa, the cloud is absolutely essential, not only to connect your devices, but to anticipate and answer the needs both in your home and beyond. And I'm happy to say that we're partnering with some of the world's top IT companies to make this vision a reality. In fact, Panasonic is working with IBM to assess the business and technical value of future home appliances connected to the cloud. Powered by IBM's advanced analytics and cloud technology, our companies will work together globally to evaluate and improve the user experience in a whole range of connected devices to the cloud and home.
It's really exciting news. Thank you so much, Joe. Thanks.
If we don't offer our guests advanced technology, connectivity, super technology loaded in the cars, or even fuel efficiency, one thing we know for certain, somebody else will.
Living in LA, obviously I spend a ton of time in my car. My gas bills are insane. My next car gonna be a hybrid or an EV, no brainer. But I mean, it's gotta be cool and affordable too.
Listen, when it comes to my car, it is so easy to get distracted. Phone, GPS, media players, sippy cups and Elmo dolls, it's all over the place. But for us, and really for me as well, the biggest priority is now safety.
In 1984, I moved to the U.S. to get my master's degree in computer science at the University of California, Santa Barbara. I learned a great deal during my time in this country, and I developed a very personal connection to one particular aspect of American innovation, the automobile. From the first time I drove this 1965 Mustang convertible. Thank you. Through 3 years as president of Panasonic Automotive Systems, to this very day, my passion for automotive technology has never diminished. And the opportunity to help our global automotive partners deliver an eco and smart driving experience. It's very exciting.
Tsuga-san, you are so studly in front of that Mustang.
Thank you.
You know, another thing that's really impressed me this week is Panasonic's breadth and depth of technology. And it really seems like this gives you such a unique opportunity to bring solutions to the automotive market.
Exactly, Lisa. That's the power of Panasonic. Our strategy for expanding our business with leading automaker is focused on two key areas. First, we are transforming our expertise in home energy solutions into total solutions for electric vehicles. And second, we are taking the engineering behind our connected home AV solutions and delivering fully connected automotive solutions. Our goal, to add value to the lives of our customers when they are on the road.
Which is so great. And the car is certainly important if you want to make an impact on energy consumption, right?
Exactly. That's why we are putting a lot of focus on expanding our business in this area.
Well, for example, I had no idea that Panasonic supplies lithium-ion batteries to power the hybrid and electric vehicles of many global automakers. In fact, I just bought a Toyota Prius plug-in, and I found out when I got here that Panasonic supplies the batteries for them.
That's a great car. And another great electric vehicle is a new Tesla S. This beautiful car is considered by many to be a game changer in the auto industry.
It is a gorgeous car, and Tesla's co-founder Elon Musk couldn't be with us today, but he sent this message.
We're very proud of our relationship with Panasonic. Working together with Panasonic has allowed us to create the most compelling and unique car in the world. And for the first time, to create an electric car, which has been declared the best car in the world by Motor Trend, by Automobile Magazine. The cell that we use is the most advanced battery cell in the world. We worked with Panasonic to modify it for an automotive application. So it's really, there's nothing else like it. And it's enabled us to make a breakthrough product that could not otherwise have existed.
Oh, I'm having such car envy. That's such a gorgeous car. I think you need to get one of those.
Yes.
But batteries are only one aspect of Panasonic EV solutions. What are some of the others?
We have taken the energy management technology we saw earlier for the home and made it applicable to electric vehicles with a power management system that greatly improves the efficiency of EV batteries. Also, we have developed a heat management system designed to reduce the tremendous power drain of air conditioning on hybrid and electric vehicles. These are just two of the new systems we are developing to make these vehicles attractive to more consumers.
It really is so exciting how efficient cars are becoming. But now let's shift the focus from eco to Panasonic's connected AV solutions for the vehicle. And to help us do that, please welcome Phil Abram, the Chief Infotainment Officer at General Motors, who's riding in style.
Thank you for joining us today.
Nice driving skills today.
Well, thank you.
So, Phil, of all the fantastic vehicles in the GM lineup, why did you choose to bring this one today?
This is the Chevrolet Malibu Eco, and it's full of technology. Its EcoTech engine allows it to get up to 37 miles per gallon. But even more relevant for today's events are the features we're adding to the Chevy MyLink infotainment system.
So, Tsuga-san, you've been underscoring the importance of listening to your customers' needs. What was GM looking for that you provided in this product?
GM is launching a new app framework across many of its vehicles and systems, including the MyLink system in this Malibu Eco that has co-developed with Panasonic. This approach opens up all kinds of possibilities for in-vehicle apps.
And so, Phil, did Panasonic deliver? Did it hit the mark for your customers?
Absolutely. While this car behind us is exciting, what's ahead of us is even more. Panasonic has delivered a great example of a flexible and customizable framework that will be a platform for future in-vehicle app innovation. Developers and customers alike will be excited about this as it allows for new apps to be created and added to their vehicle after the initial purchase. Today, when a customer purchases a vehicle, the infotainment features are fixed and stay the same throughout the entire ownership experience. You basically have to wait until you buy your next new car to get new features. With this new app framework, GM customers will be able to access a catalog and download apps to their vehicle as they become available. This means your car, which is great when you buy it, continues to get better and more customized over time, and you choose the app and features you want for your vehicle. This is all part of GM's commitment to safely bringing customer-centric technology to our vehicles and building a developer ecosystem so that developers can join us in the journey of exploring what is possible. In fact, GM just launched the software development kit for developers to create in-vehicle apps using an approach leveraging HTML5 to make it easier for them to develop apps for our cars. This demonstration vehicle shows some of the apps that could be available to customers from our catalog on the screen. Then, as additional apps become available, customers will be able to choose the ones they want from a growing list created for the car, allowing drivers to use them while keeping their eyes on the road and their hands on the wheel. We look forward to continued collaboration with Panasonic and delivering this system to select GM vehicles this year.
We do as well, Phil. Thank you all so much for being here today.
Thank you, Tsuga-san.
Thanks, Phil. Drive safely.
Thank you.
Okay, Tsuga-san, so what do you think is coming next?
Panasonic has a full shelf of current and emerging interface technology that will make your driving experience safer and smarter than ever before. But the auto industry is just one category of Panasonic business solutions. There are many more.
There are a lot of great business tools out there, but finding comprehensive tools that talk to each other, that work together seamlessly, that's what we really need.
My goal for my employees is to provide the most exceptional service possible. So as an owner, I need to provide them the most state-of-the-art technology and tools that can allow them to achieve this.
There's no question that technology is revolutionizing the way that young, creative entrepreneurs and everyone is able to connect and share ideas around the world. As I look at it for myself, as my business grows, I know that I'm gonna need smart solutions that help me take it to the next level.
So there may be no better demonstration of how Panasonic is listening to its business customers and customizing smart solutions to meet their needs than the fast-growing ToughPad and ToughBook business. With their rugged design and ability to withstand extreme conditions, these workhorse tools have become invaluable on a whole range of job sites. Tonight, Panasonic is hosting a special event to launch some fantastic new technology that's going to take ToughPad to a whole new level. But right now, we're here to talk about a new Panasonic tool engineered to answer a unique set of business customer needs, and Joe's here to tell us about it.
This is a new Panasonic 4K tablet. It's less than a half inch thick, it's Windows 8 based, and this business tool is incredibly light, incredibly thin, and incredibly portable. But I think what really sets it apart, if you look at this 20-inch screen, look at the pictures.
The image is amazing. This 4K image is just stunning.
It's amazing.
So I understand this also has a stylus.
It does.
What does that do?
Well, I'm going to show you.
This is it?
Let's say, for example, you're an architect and you're working remotely on a job site. You've got your blueprints and you want to make some changes. You can make the changes.
I can write on this?
Right on here.
That's why I'm not an architect, Joe. I don't.
So we can take these images, these changes you just made, and through the cloud, we can send them directly back to the home office.
And so what other ways or uses do you envision with this?
Well, we actually gave one of these 4K tablets to a real Panasonic customer. This is a Pulitzer Prize-nominated photographer whose work has appeared in publications all around the world. Why don't we take a look and see what he thought about it?
As a photojournalist, it's important to meet with magazine editors and clients, and having a tablet, having a product like this with high resolution, also a 20-inch large screen, would be very, very useful. I often edit my photos on location, and it'd be very beneficial to have a high resolution screen and pen to be able to go into the detail of the photographs and see the whole image. Another way I would like to use the product is as a remote viewing tool, to be able to mount a camera remotely for, let's say, a news event, and to be able to control the focusing, also the exposure of the product, which would be very, very advantageous and very exciting. Using a tool like this, being able to edit my images on location, and also to be able to do it with a lot more precision on a larger size tablet, I really look forward to using this product.
So those are just two examples of how this tablet could be used.
Yeah, and you really need to see this up close to fully appreciate the 4K resolution and wide viewing angle. It's spectacular.
And you really should do that in our booth today.
Okay, so then, Joe, I'm gonna leave the business strategy up to you and take this. Take
Great.
It away.
Thank you. Thanks, Lisa. Panasonic solutions for business are incredibly diverse. For example, in the manufacturing space, every one of the top five global smartphone makers depends on Panasonic technology to build their devices. In the retail space, our B2B2C strategy is providing end-to-end solutions that leverage the expertise of all of our companies, from audiovisual to energy solutions. By enhancing those solutions with a variety of Panasonic services, such as consulting, maintenance, and the cloud, We're able to custom tailor an approach that meets the exact needs of our individual customers. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. In Asia, Panasonic is partnering with a Japanese-based convenience store chain with over 11,000 stores around the world, Lawson's. Since the earthquake in 2011, managing and conserving energy has become more important than ever for Japanese businesses. But Panasonic and Lawson's has actually been ahead of the curve on all of this. In 2010, we created a prototype green store that integrates a wide variety of Panasonic products, resulting in a 20% reduction in power consumption as compared to 2006. Last year, we began installing solar panels in over 2,000 Lawson stores. And in the future, Lawson's has plans to expand the number of green stores to 10,000, with Panasonic contributing innovative new solutions that include a comprehensive energy management system. When it comes to smart business solutions, there may be no better example than how we're helping the world's leading food service retailer, McDonald's. Take a look.
At McDonald's, our customers come first. So we're going to offer them a place where they get great quality food and a clean restaurant with friendly and accurate service.
Hello, welcome to McDonald's.
We realize that society's changing and our customer demands are changing with that. So technology is more crucial than it ever has been in delivering this experience that we want. We believe in our 18 locations that embracing Panasonic has enabled us to achieve those expectations. We have Panasonic TVs, POS, handhelds, camera systems, headsets. My front counter talks to my kitchen talks to my drive-thru. The great part about Panasonic items is they all work seamlessly together. At the end of the day, my customer gets what they want.
As we look to the future, there's no question that Panasonic will offer an even wider range of eco and smart solutions to the answer needs of all of our business customers.
My job requires that I travel all over the world, and one of the biggest challenges that I have always being out of the office is staying productive. That's especially a problem when I'm in flight and I need to be connected to my team. If an airline could help me solve that problem, they would earn my business.
You know, I try to be as green as I possibly can, but due to the amount of air travel I do, my carbon footprint is just much larger than I would like it to be. I mean, I can't stop flying, but I would surely love to feel better about it.
Traveling with small kids is, let's just say it's an adventure. The last flight we were on with my infant and two-year-old, I think what got us through was having one of those touchscreen video players on the seat back in front of my two-year-old. That way she could watch whatever she wanted to and she could actually touch the screen and make it happen. Her choice was SpongeBob to most of us. But I think without that, I don't know what I would have done. And I think it was a lifesaver. Just ask the people sitting in front of us.
Panasonic technology is creating memorable journeys for travelers around the world every single day. At the airport, in the lounge, and especially on board your flights for both passengers and crew. With 275 airline customers in our portfolio, and more than 5,000 airplanes around the world fitted with our in-flight entertainment and communications systems. Last year, more than 500 million passengers experienced the journeys enhanced by Panasonic avionics solutions. In 2013, Panasonic's next generation systems are taking avionics technology to the next level, including over 1,600 planes committed with broadband internet. With so many customers, it's difficult to select the best stories to share with you. Lisa.
Thanks, Suga-san. Since 1998, Panasonic has partnered with one of the world's largest airlines and consequently one of their most important customers, United Airlines. With Panasonic in-flight entertainment and communication systems installed across both wide and narrow body fleets, including the new 787 Dreamliner, 2013 is definitely taking the partnership to the next level. This year, United will become Panasonic's largest global communication suite customer, installing the state-of-the-art solution, including high-speed internet access, email, social media, and streaming media on over 300 aircraft flying routes all over the world. It's a partnership that I know both companies are very, very excited about.
Panasonic's been helping United enhance the customer experience for many years now. And with connectivity so important to our customers, Panasonic is coming up with innovative ideas to meet their needs. We're confident as the new system rolls out, we'll set a new standard for the industry and, more importantly, our passengers. We're excited about the future of what our companies can achieve together.
I'm excited about that because I practically live on United Airlines. But our next guest is an exceptional leader in the global airline industry and one of Panasonic's most valued partners. Please welcome the recent CEO of Air New Zealand, chairman of the Star Alliance, and member of the Board of Governors at IATA, Rob Fyfe. Thank you, Rob. Thanks for being here, Rob. Now, this partnership with Panasonic must be important for you to have flown all the way from New Zealand to be here.
That's true, almost 14 hours flying, so a long way.
How are you feeling?
Not bad, a couple of movies, good sleep, I'm in pretty good shape.
Okay, good, because you're only standing in front of 3,000 people, so no pressure or anything. Now, one of the recurring themes of this morning is Panasonic's commitment to innovation and listening to their customers. So, Tsuga-san, when partners like Air New Zealand come to you for solutions, what are they asking for?
Our airline partners must create amazing personal experience for their passengers. Experiences that create loyal customers. That is why our solutions must be more than just incredible entertainment system.
And Rob, Air New Zealand has a long history of innovation, and under your leadership, it was named Airline of the Year by ATW 2 times in the last 3 years. Congratulations on that honor. Only a handful of airlines have achieved that recognition. But what are some of the biggest challenges you have when it comes to delivering value to your customers?
Well, unlike our good friends in Star Alliance partner United, we're not one of the world's largest airlines. So lacking scale means we rely on innovation, on agility, on adapting quickly to change for our competitive advantage. And we need partners that share our quest for innovation and customer-centred design. And with New Zealand being such a remote country on the bottom of the South Pacific Ocean, many of our journeys are 12 hours or longer. So having the absolute best in-flight entertainment and communication systems is essential to keep our customers engaged, entertained, connected, and inspired by the destination they're coming to visit or returning from. And Panasonic has proven to be the ideal partner for us in realizing both those ambitions.
Yeah, there's nothing worse than being really bored on a long flight. True. So what are some of the high points in your relationship with Panasonic?
Well, for Air New Zealand, customer-enhancing technologies are critical at every step of the journey, from the online booking process to check-in to the journey through the airport and onto the aircraft. And Panasonic has been involved with us in every step of that journey. In-flight entertainment technologies are one of our biggest investments, and we have Panasonic systems on both our long-haul and short-haul aircraft. One of the biggest challenges economically is justifying the business case to upgrade the older aircraft and some of the older systems. We recently challenged Panasonic to come up with a much lighter, lower cost system without compromising the customer experience, and they've delivered a fantastic outcome for us, which is X-Lite.
X-Lite, so tell us, what is X-Lite, Tsuga-san?
The X-Lite system we are launching with Air New Zealand in 2014 is the lowest power and lightest weight in-flight entertainment solution we have ever offered.
So are your passengers responding to X-Lite?
Oh, the consumer testing we've done is fantastic. It delivers on every level, so it's lower cost for us. It's much lighter. The customer experience is fantastic. And with New Zealand being one of the greenest countries in the world, it's important to us that we have an environmentally friendly solution, and X-Lite delivers that. So we're thrilled. We think Panasonic's got a real world-beating system here, so it's fantastic.
Well, a bunch of our American airlines need to jump on that bandwagon, because it sounds like Air New Zealand is the most fun airline. Thank you, gentlemen, so much for trying to enhance our travel experience. I know as a frequent traveler, I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lisa. Thanks, Kees.
As individuals, we do what we can to make a difference. But when I think about the impact that large companies can have on an entire community, I want to see more of that.
The sports entertainment business is all about bringing people together, whether it's the consumer or the brand partners that we have. And using cutting-edge technology in order to be able to do that is paramount to our day-to-day business.
I think creating a better world is one that utilizes the correct ingredients that are sustainable, affordable, and when you can bring those ingredients to a private home and then the community adopts those technologies, you really start to have an effect that's meaningful.
Panasonic is providing integrated solutions to enhance communities of all kinds, from informational kiosks and digital signage at leading universities to energy solutions that are making auto racing more sustainable, to comprehensive solutions enjoyed by audiences at arenas and performance venues.
And when it comes to global impact, no event embodies Panasonic's vision for a better world more than the Olympic Games. As the official worldwide AV sponsor, Panasonic's end-to-end broadcast solutions have made it possible for audiences around the world to share the passion of the games for 25 years. In addition to that, for nearly a decade, Panasonic has also sponsored US Major League Soccer, a relationship that includes a whole range of integrated solutions in MLS stadiums around the country.
In fact, at last year's Summer Games in London, these two partnerships came together beautifully with the spectacular gold medal-winning performance of the US women's soccer team, featuring these standout players.
Hey everyone, Abby and I really wanted to take the time today to thank our friends at Panasonic for their amazing support of our team.
Thanks to Panasonic technology, fans in the US were able to watch the London 2012 Summer Olympics in 3D, where, if you didn't hear, we happen to win this.
With your support and the continued support of Panasonic, hopefully we'll be able to do it again 4 years from now in Rio.
In the meantime, please keep watching. We love our fans.
Thanks again, everyone.
But Joe, we've just scratched the surface of Panasonic's eco and smart community solutions, haven't we?
That's right, Lisa. Why don't we take a deeper dive into a couple more examples?
Sounds good. Tokyo Skytree in Japan, if you're unfamiliar with it, is the world's tallest freestanding broadcast tower. And thanks to Panasonic's spectacular LED lighting installation, it's become one of the top destinations in Asia. It's really beautiful. These state-of-the-art bulbs are not only stunning, but they deliver a 43% savings on energy consumption.
But if you really want to see how Panasonic energy solutions are being scaled far beyond the home, let's talk about sustainable smart towns. We're playing a key role in a number of these projects around the world, including one currently under construction in Fujisawa, Japan. When it opens next year, this state-of-the-art green community will be home to thousands of people who will be living in a city that integrates a whole range of solutions to create, store, save, and manage energy on a vast scale. And although still early in development, this is a business model that we're going to be replicating globally.
We'd love to replicate that here in the United States for sure. But perhaps the most compelling demonstration of Panasonic's commitment to engineering a better world can be found right in our own backyard with the construction of the company's new North American headquarters.
So this summer, Panasonic's North American headquarters is moving from Secaucus, New Jersey to a brand new facility in Newark, New Jersey. And it's a move that represents our commitment at Panasonic North America to reduce our own carbon footprint by about 50%. As well as creating a state-of-the-art, environmentally responsible workplace for our employees. And this new high-rise building is designed to be a showcase for both our customers and our stakeholders that will incorporate the most innovative Panasonic eco technologies and business solutions. And the building itself will be LEED Gold certified, but our space, the inside space, our expectation is it'll be LEED Platinum certified, like your home.
Awesome. Now, one of Panasonic's key partners in this project is well known for his own commitment to community. Please welcome the mayor of Newark, New Jersey, Cory Booker.
Hey, Cory. Good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
My pleasure.
Good to see you.
Hello.
Thanks for being here with us today.
I am psyched to be here today.
Well, so it's no secret that Newark has faced some big challenges, as many as any big American city. So how important was it for Panasonic to base its headquarters in your city, Newark?
I mean, it was huge. Seven years ago when I became mayor, things were so difficult with crime, the city's budget, jobs. I used to tell people, I'm a prisoner of hope. I believe I'm a prisoner of hope. But with Panasonic coming to Newark, they have transformed my metaphor. I now say I'm hope unhinged. Because here is a company that's come in and helped to stimulate growth. They've been the ignition point for so much great activity. They've gotten involved in everything with technology, from our police department helping us to be more cutting edge, to creating soon an idea center to ignite the ideas of innovators of the future. And then also they're helping to resonate their values with ours in things like green building and stimulating a new economy.
So companies like Panasonic are literally transforming Newark.
Absolutely. This is our biggest economic development period since the 1950s. Literally $1 billion of investment last year, new billion coming in soon. But the trigger point really is a Panasonic. They really have created in Newark. They've been the harbingers of hope.
Wow. So Joe, one of the main motivations in moving to an urban transit like Newark is mass transit for your employees. Why was that so important?
Well, we wanted to connect our employees and our green vision. And we couldn't have a green vision if we had 1,000 people driving their cars to work every day. So this mass transit was absolutely essential to achieve our carbon footprint reduction.
Now, I know a lot of cities probably wanted Panasonic to base their headquarters in their own city. Why did you choose Newark?
Because of my good looks and my charm.
Undeniably, yes. Of course.
So I can tell you it wasn't financial. We had a number of opportunities that from a fiscal perspective were certainly much better. But none of those other cities had Mayor Booker. That's a true statement.
This is true,
thank you for saying that.
But I think for us, this was an opportunity for us to quite literally put a stake in the ground for our company core values and help transform a city.
Yeah. And I think that's key. I mean, the reality is in America, we have these domestic emerging markets. And Panasonic, I found, is a company that doesn't just have values that they put up on a wall or that they preach. They actually live those values. And so this idea of green, of recycling, means a statement that there are no throwaway communities, there are no throwaway cities. Every place has value. And what they're doing now, in my opinion, is probably the most important calling of any American generation, which is to call to the moral consciousness of a country, to get them to dream bigger, to do more, to believe in the promise of tomorrow.
Well, it sounds like with Panasonic's presence and hopefully other companies, Newark is going to look like a totally different city in a few years.
You know, it's rapidly changing as we in America start to see the power of metropolitan areas. We're 12 miles from New York City. But it really takes a visionary company, not just to understand the markets of today, understand where we are as a country today, but the beauty of Panasonic, I'm finding from leaders like Joe, is that they are anticipating where this nation is going. Not just anticipating it, they're reimagining it. And that, to me, is what's so critical right now for cities like Newark, but our globe as a whole.
So exciting.
Yeah, I'm not sure it's just visionary companies. I think maybe visionary mayors who can show companies the vision of what companies could actually do. And I really want to thank you for showing us the contribution that we might be able to make and welcoming us into your community.
Well, I want to thank you right here as publicly as I can for believing in Newark, but more importantly, in this time where people are surrendering to cynicism, where negativity about our economy, about our politics, you guys have injected the power of belief. And I think when people have that energy, when they have that view, when they have that kind of hope, impossible things become possible. And that's the kind of company and leadership that you have. So thank you.
Thanks so much, Mayor Booker.
Thank you.
Thanks. You know, I have one beef with the mayor.
You have a beef with him?
I have one beef with the mayor. So in life, we meet people that are incredibly smart, or incredibly good-looking, or incredibly talented athletically. And that's great, one by one. But is it fair that one person should have all of those things?
Yeah, I know. It's okay if you have a little man crush on Cory Booker, Joe. It's okay, we're secure in our masculinity here, right?
The secret's out.
Thank you, Joe. This is a very powerful story. Thank you for leading this project. I'm confident that this move will re-energize our company and reinvent Panasonic North America as an eco-engineering leader.
Thanks, Kaz. I'm quite sure that it will.
Oh, and Lisa, thank you for helping us share our company's story today. We couldn't have done it without you.
It's been such a pleasure. Thank you.
But perhaps our greatest thanks goes to the customers who shared what matters most to them today.
My TV.
My business.
My journey.
A better home.
A better community.
A better world.
For me.
For us.
For our family.
As you've seen over the last hour, there are many visions of a better world as there are people on our planet. I sincerely hope that you live here today with a sense of our vision and a commitment to make the world better. With you, together, one customer at a time, one home at a time, one community at a time. Some of what we've shared today may seem quite bold, unexpected, perhaps different than the Panasonic you have known in the past. But if we are to achieve our goals, the imperative to transform and innovate has never been greater for our company, and I believe for our industry. However, the core values that drive us at Panasonic are not new at all. They have actually been part of our company's DNA since it was founded by Konosuke Matsushita nearly 100 years ago.
They say you get wiser with age. I don't know about that, but I do know what matters most.
To place people before products.
Preserving the planet for our kids, that's everything.
To contribute to our society.
Making life easier for our employees, for our customers, for the people we serve. That's really what it's all about.
To enhance and add value to the lives of customers.
Making the world a better place? I mean, isn't that what we're all here for?
And to offer eco and smart solutions that make what matters most better. This is who we are and who we have always been. When all is said and done, it's just another way we are engineering a better world for you. Thank you very much.